man to cut this shit.
We got speed on the recorder. Okay. So, not to bore interview with this next bit of information. Man, damn that. I honestly could care less if it bores any of you. In my life right about now, I don't deal with too many shades of gray, meaning you either all in or all out. I'm learning that there are a lot of elements in my life, including people that I just don't need. I'm gonna get back to why I'm saying this in a second. When I got started with this passion project, the Joe Blackula Perspective, I first decided that I just wanted to do a commentary on movies. Then I figured at some point, man, the hell with it, I'm just gonna express myself. If folks see it, cool. If folk don't see it, whatever the hell. At least I'll be able to fine tune and work on what I wanna do. Plus, this will be my own way of contributing to this cesspool that we like to call social media, as well as showcasing my various skill sets that I've been blessed with. So out the gate, I asked my friend Ayana, since I've known since kindergarten, since 1977, do the math on that one. Susanna Wesley was the name of the school, 7600 South St. Lawrence here in Chicago. During that time period, at that time, since that time, her mother, Paulette Corley, has become a very important person to me. Be it if I only see her once a year or every 2 years. She means a lot to me because a lot of people don't get me. Won't get me, don't like me, but I think that Paulette Corley does. But if she doesn't, then I ain't been able to tell in my lifetime. I mean, if I ever missed her birthday, missed her Mother's Day, which are the only two holidays that I'm really concerned about verbally expressing with someone, but if I ever missed one of those, then it was truly some form of communication screw up on my end. It definitely is a blame it on my head and not on my heart scenario. I was born with a big head with a lot of brain. I was also born with a condition called a Chiari malformation. I got a 7-inch scar down the back of my head from two brain surgeries, which is why I tend to ramble sometimes. But truth be told, I've never really felt comfortable around most people. I've always either been the shortest male in the room, the fattest, the quietest, something where I'm not quite up to par with everyone else. This also includes being in the same room with family members as well, people that I'm genetically related to. This goes back to my shades of gray statement. Like the Sith in Star Wars, Sith deal with absolutes.
If you're not with me, then you're my enemy.
Only a Sith deals in absolutes.
Either you're in or you're out. Do or do not. There is no try. But now that I think about it, Yoda said that. And Yoda wasn't Sith.
No. Try not. Do or do not. There is no try.
I digress. I go on these tangents with people from time to time. I always regret it. I get bottled up, spout off, say things, say the truth that I need to keep to myself, or either tell it to a therapist. And I get feedback and I listen to what other folk have to say. But I honestly could care less. It's the fact that I was raised right why I don't tell these people to go on about their business. But Paulette Corley, she has been one of the consistent persons because she is of the few, on my one hand, that I have fully felt comfortable with expressing my true thoughts and concerns and actually wanting to hear the feedback. She's lived a life and has a perspective that I've respected and has given me more emotional feedback than my own mother, who Paulette also knew while my mother was alive. That's not taking anything away from my mother. My mother just wasn't built for helpful words of expression. She wasn't the one to go to if you were feeling a certain kind of way, you know? I'm pinging all over the place. Let me get centered here. See, even during a moment like this, if I'm trying to get my thoughts together in front of Paulette, I never feel rushed, never feel like I'm losing the room. For the most part, it's hard for me to wrangle all of my thoughts together in 146 characters. So when I decided I was gonna start reviewing these movies, and Ayana let me know that her mother Paulette wasn't doing too well, the absolute least I could do is to ask Ayana to ask her mother Paulette for a movie to review, and that movie was Harriet. Now, I had no immediate intentions to even watching Harriet out the gate. I'm sure that I was gonna see it, but it wasn't on my priority list. Hell, I don't even have a priority list right about now. I do have a list of 56 movies that I plan on getting to, so I've been kinda going down on one at a time. But for Paulette, I created a priority list. And I put Harriet like right at the top of it. Not literally, but you know what I mean. No, damn that. I literally put Harriet at the top of the priority list. Yes, I did do that. So please note that the review for Harriet, that review ain't meant for y'all. This is meant for you, mother dear. Paulette Corley. Hopefully she gives me more of them to do. Nope. Damn that. I'm gonna speak this one into existence. I'm looking forward to Paulette giving me more of them to do. And at those moments, I'm gonna let y'all know. But Paulette, mother dear, if you only watch this review for Harriet, the one time, and if inshallah you never hear my voice again or see my face in person again in life, cause tomorrow ain't promised to no man walking on 2 feet, that as long as my voice and my face can give you at least one moment of pleasure or at least one moment of relief from any discomfort, that I did what was needed, and I love you very much. That's it. That's all.